instance, that the heresy should be without a cause, but my heart standeth in awe of thy mind.
I'm the eternal Ephesus. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us, and write both these thy laws on our hearts, who beseech thee.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high.
And in peace, goodwill towards man. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God our Father. Amen.
The Lord be with
you. And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O God, has bestowed upon thy saints such marvelous virtue that they were able to stand fast and have their victory against the world, the flesh, and the devil, grant that we who now commemorate thy martyr George may ever rejoice in their fellowship, and also be enabled by thy grace to fight the good fight of faith and lay hold upon eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who with thee and the Holy Spirit liveth and reigneth one God for ever and ever.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the epistle, the first epistle general of St. Peter, in the fourth chapter, beginning at the 12th verse. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. But rejoice, inasmuch as ye are partakers of the sufferings of Christ, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. If ye be reproached for the name of Christ, blessed are ye, for the Spirit of glory and of God resteth upon you. On their part he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified. But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as a busybody in other men's matters. But if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God in this name. For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? And if righteousness scarcely be saved, if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit their keeping to the keeping of their souls to Him, in well doing, as unto a faithful Creator. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. What reward shall I give unto the Lord for all the benefits that He hath done unto me?
I will take up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows unto the Lord in the presence of His people. Alleluia.
Dear in the sight of the Lord is the death of His saints. Alleluia.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 16th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the 24th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
Then said Jesus unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. Whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. For what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? For the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then shall he reward every man according to his work.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please be seated. You think after all these years of being a Christian, finding surprises in the New Testament. But once again, I am surprised. I had never before thought to look up how many times the word martyr is used in the New Testament. It should be a very easy thing. I thought I would find all manner of references to it. But, mea culpa, I did not. I found, count them, three uses of the word martyr in the New Testament. The first refers to Saint Stephen, who is known throughout the church as the first martyr, the proto-martyr. The others refer to us. Now, the important part about the word martyr is that its original meaning was one as a witness, as in somebody is arrested for not abiding by the 2-meter rule in this time, and they receive a $1,200 ticket. A witness who saw that, in fact, the person charged was not breaking the 6-foot or 2-meter distance, but instead was surprised by a walker coming up and refusing to leave enough space. That witness is a martyr, for he witnessed the occasion and he testified about it. Saint George the Martyr is known throughout the church. Saint George is also revered in the Eastern Church with a magnificent set of titles, some of which I cannot remember at the moment. But it ends up with his being Saint George the Triumphant, blah, 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 blah. Saint George the Triumphant. How is he triumphant? Saint George is triumphant in that the legends that grew up about him were of his triumph in his martyrdom, that he was so faithful a Christian that although he did not seek martyrdom, these are to some extent common speculations, but there they are, that he was executed after being tortured under Diocletian around the year 303 AD. Now, this is about all we know about St. George. But he is also known as a saint whose invocation leads to wonderful miracles. The Western Church long ago numbered him among the 14 auxiliary saints, that is, helper saints. The Eastern Church simply carried on revering this soldier saint. By the Middle Ages, the Western Church was involved in all manner of interesting military movements at the other end of the empire, in other words, around Constantinople and the Holy Land. And our friend George became known as a
knight who went about rectifying all sorts of ills in the eastern end of the Mediterranean. Now, what do we have here with St. George? We have, in effect, something along the lines of an old Western hero. A hero who comes into town, finds that the Christians are being persecuted, and he talks his way out. But one time, tradition says in Lydda, he didn't manage to convert the pagans. And so he was arrested, he was tortured, he would not recant, and eventually someone beheaded him. Now, this is the story. It may or may not be true. I remember years ago I preached a sermon based on a paper I had written. And if anyone is really sorely interested, I can probably summarize it for you afterward, but you didn't have to ask. So St. George became a very important saint. He was of great popularity, especially after the Last Crusade, wherein it is said that he appeared and saved the troops, for he was, after all, a soldier. Now, George then became unremittedly popular in Western Europe, as well as in Eastern Europe, where he had been wildly popular long before. And so when the Crusaders returned home, they brought with them the stories of St. George the Martyr. King Edward III, talk about trivia, King Edward III placed his new order of knights under the patronage of St. I've lost it, the actual saint, who is patron saint of England, and under the protection of St. George. Now, lost it again. Okay, humility comes from humiliation many a time. So the Order of the Garter, which still exists today, was under the patriot protection of St. George. Now, George technically is not the patron saint of England, despite what I seem to recall learning in elementary school, but rather it is this wonderful king whose name has escaped me. The reality of it all is it doesn't matter a hoot. What does matter is that St. George, the soldier, the martyr, the triumphant, is to be our example. Just as St. John the Baptist, who in the prayer book for his days, we read he boldly rebuked vice. Now there's something that our parish priest probably doesn't want to do very much, as neither did I. But on occasion, we have to boldly rebuke vice. These things that we are called to do under the canopy of St. George the Martyr praying for us are acts of courage, because he is indeed the patron saint of courage. I have read it nowhere, and although I do not claim any original thought save one in my St. Stephen is called the proto-martyr, but I submit to you that the first martyr, the first witness who died, was Jesus Christ, our Lord, who died as witness to his Father. St. Stephen then became the martyr who would not condemn Christ our Lord, who would not recant of the truth of the gospel. And St. George was doing the same thing 200 and whatever number of years later. St. George was doing the same. We in our lives are frequently called to witness for Christ in any kind of circumstances. We, like George, are called to be people who stand up for the truth of the gospel whenever it is that the Holy Spirit gives us a slap across the back of the head. We are called to be martyrs in the original sense of a witness. And who knows, someday each of us may be called to be martyrs in the more contemporary sense. That is, a witness who is called to die for the one holy Catholic and apostolic faith of the Church. So, all of us potential martyrs, let us then have hope in everything we do, because no matter how bad situations may be, no matter how we may be tied up in anger or in fear or in whatever else there may be, we have wonderful saints who are praying for us to the Father, and not the least among them is St. George, the triumphant, St. George, the martyr. Edward the Confessor. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. All thy words praise thee, O Lord, and thy saints give thanks unto thee. They show the glory of thy kingdom and talk of thy power. Alleluia. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive the sacrifice at thy hands for the praise and glory of his name, both for our benefit and that of his holy church.
Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel, forever and ever. All that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. All things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The holy sacrifice is offered to the honor and glory of Almighty God in high thanksgiving and great praise for the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for all the benefits that accrue to us through his wondrous death and resurrection. It is offered in thanksgiving for the life and work and witness and continuing prayers of St. George the Triumphant and martyr. It is offered for all parishes and congregations dedicated in the title of the Resurrection and of St. George. It is offered for the whole church dispersed throughout the world, for the traditional Anglican Communion, for the Anglican Catholic Church of Canada, for all faithful Christian clergy and people. It is offered for all who grieve, for all who have lost their lives due to this plague. It is offered for all those who died in the Nova Scotia slaughter. Is offered for the sick, injured, recovering, and dying. It is offered for each of us that we may be made worthy by the power of the Holy Spirit of being found faithful to Christ. Let us pray for Christ's holy Catholic Church. Almighty and ever-living God, by thy holy apostle hast taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men. We humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant thee also to lead all nations in the way of righteousness, and so to guide and direct their governors and rulers, that thy people may enjoy the blessings of freedom and peace. And grant unto thy servant Elizabeth, our queen, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, and especially to thy servant Shane, our bishop and primate, Robert, our parish priest, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and living word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. Prosper, we pray thee, all those who proclaim the gospel of thy kingdom among the nations, and to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of thy life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, especially those for whom our prayers are desired. We remember before thee, O Lord, all thy servants departed this life in thy faith
and fear. Beseeching thee to grant them a place of refreshment, light, and peace, and may bless thy holy name for all who in life and death have glorified thee, chiefly the glorious and most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, the holy patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, Saint George the Triumphant, and all thy saints. Beseeching thee to give us grace that, rejoicing in their fellowship, we may follow their good examples, and with them be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Even to truly and earnestly repent of their sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead the new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneel upon your knees. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things and judge of all men, we acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. Have mercy upon us, most merciful God.
For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all our sins, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life,
to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that labour and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to receive, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. But if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
He is right and right, Saint Jude.
It is very neat, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, Creator and Preserver of all things, who in the multitude of thy saints hast compassed us about with so great a cloud of witnesses, that we, rejoicing in their fellowship, may run with patience the race that is set before us, and together with them may receive the crown of glory that fadeth not away. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord, most high. Bless Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessing and glory and thanksgiving be unto the Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, a perpetual memorial of that his precious death, until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we must come to this institute, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. In the same night that he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, gave it to them, saying, for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as you shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, we thy humble servants with all thy holy church, remembering the precious death of thy beloved Son, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again in glory, to make before thee, in this sacrament of the holy bread of eternal life, and the cup of everlasting salvation, the memorial which he hath commanded, we entirely desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole in remission of our sins and all of the benefits of his passion. We pray that by the power of thy Holy Spirit, all we who are partakers of this holy communion may be fulfilled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, God, throughout all ages, world without end.
Amen.
Spirit.
thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed with his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sin of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Lord,
I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof. But speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
I shall rejoice in the Lord and put his trust in him, and all they that are true of heart shall be glad. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord
and with thy spirit.
Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee that thou dost graciously feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, assuring us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are living members of his mystical body, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope thy everlasting kingdom. And here we offer and present to thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. And although we are unworthy, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Grant, we beseech thee, O Lord our God, that like as we in this life do gladly honor the memory of thy saints, so we may in heaven rejoice in their eternal fellowship. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be
with
thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks
be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Blessed, praised, hallowed, and adored be our Lord Jesus Christ on his throne of glory in heaven, in the most holy sacrament of the altar, in the hearts of all his faithful people. Amen.